Shifting sands reflect change that is gradual and never-ending, making it an apt theme for this year's Eval Fest. It was a three-day evaluation festival that brought together some of the world's finest sector experts, creating a melting pot of ideas, innovations, and insights. We at Sambodhi are deeply committed to bringing these learnings to you, but with a twist of our own. Presenting Evidence Dialogues, a conversation series born out of the many stories that were left uncaptured during the sessions at EvalFest. With this series, we bring to you a stellar lineup of sector experts talking about their experiences and the countless learnings they've gathered in their journey of bringing transformation. We spoke to Sebastian, Director of Evaluation at 3IE, about the role of technology in an ever-evolving evaluation landscape. We also talked about the emerging role of AI and ML in strengthening processes and increasing efficiencies, while also taking on the all-too-pervasive question of, will AI replace human skill? Thank you so much for joining us, Sebastian. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Great, Aishwarya. I'm really happy to join you and happy to be part of EvalFest 2024.
Thank you. Speaking of which, we have been talking a lot about AI and ML, that's artificial intelligence and machine learning, in the context of this Evaluation Fest, right? And a lot of conversations have happened around its applications. Can you give us some insights on the same from your perspectives or your work at 3IE about the same?
Absolutely. So at the International Initiative for Impact Evaluation, or 3IE, we're really excited about the potential for bringing in AI into the practice of evaluation, and specifically of impact evaluation, where we're attempting to use data-driven approaches to establishing causal effects in development programs and policies. So I think we're, you know, really at the very early stages of learning how to harness this technology for use in evaluation. But you know, I think every day learning about new promising applications. So just to give you sort of a sense of some of the areas that we've been working in, we've seen tremendous promise from AI, in particular large language models, to help us sort through just vast quantities of text data when we're doing our initial scoping, when we're, you know, essentially doing sort of lit review type work for all of the synthesis area. There's a large team at 3IE that works in synthesis and is exploring, you know, very actively the applications of AI for to enhance the efficiency of their work. Also bringing in machine learning techniques into our data analysis at various levels and various stages, from sort of the, you know, initial data collection, you know, sampling, and you know, using AI to identify our sample frame in a more efficient way. For example, using satellite images to identify a given population, the actual econometric analysis where we're trying to tease out, for example, heterogeneous impacts using causal forests. And so that's an area that's grown, you know, in the last maybe decade or so, has grown very rapidly as an application to data analysis. And I think, you know, really pertinent to applications in the field of impact evaluation. We, you know, we also have more, let's say, mundane uses of AI. The chatbots that all of us have become, I think, really accustomed to provide, you know, a very friendly resource for our day-to-day work, like coding. And so we're able to, you know, sort of leverage that technology to become just more efficient at our work and getting things done slightly more quickly and increasing, you know, our efficiency and productivity. So again, I think we've just really scratched the, you know, scratched the surface on what we can do with AI, but we're really excited for what that future has to hold.
Right. You just spoke about AI as a complementary tool, right? But you also just said that we're just scratching the surface. What do you mean when you say we're scratching the surface? If it is just a complementary tool, do you think that it'll evolve into something that's a bit more sophisticated in terms of doing the work that seasoned professionals may be doing at this point in time?
I mean, I have no doubt that the level of sophistication of the technology and the applications will grow over time. I mean, I think that is probably where the future is. But at least in the medium to short run, I see, you know, AI applications as really being enhancing our tool set. So it's bringing in technology to allow us to do types of analysis, process different types of data that probably didn't even exist, 20 years ago, maybe even 10 years ago. So as the, data environment becomes more complex, we have new tools to come in and analyze and use those data to do, important work in the field of development. But I think the basic elements of impact evaluation practice, in particular, the practice of applying rigorous empirical tools to answer policy relevant questions, isn't something that AI is going to very easily be able to come in and substitute for, at least not very soon. So maybe a few decades out, will be somewhere closer to that, but I think that a skilled evaluator who really understands the intricacies not only of establishing a causal effect and backing out causal attribution, but also can work with program implementers, can work with policymakers to implement an evaluation that is actually feasible in the field, that doesn't fall apart, that doesn't create major complications in terms of implementation. All of that nuance is not something that that AI currently has the knowledge or capacity to do on its own. So really it's about bringing in the tools of AI to make our evaluators more efficient at what they do. So I think their productivity will go up. They'll actually be busier than they were in the past, and that's sort of the trend, at least in my mind, that we've seen whenever one of these sort of technological revolutions takes place. Is that while some segments of the labor market may be directly affected, other segments of the labor market actually get busier. So I think that's what's going to happen in the field of evaluation. That would be my prediction.
Based on that prediction then, I also want to understand what the capacity building aspect of it looks like. Because yes, we talk about AI and ML and the benefits that they can have on productivity and efficiency, but for that to happen, it has to be accessible to all as well, right? And how are we as an ecosystem making sure that that actually ends up happening? Where's the capacity building area coming into play?
I mean, I think that's a really important point, and I think that democratizing access and knowledge around these tools is going to become increasingly important, because we obviously don't want to leave anyone behind in terms of their ability to leverage and use these kinds of tools. And so keeping up in terms of skills and keeping up in terms of experience and even just having the opportunity, the insight to identifying where bringing in the tools of AI is a good fit and in what aspects of our work it's not. Because I don't think that AI, again, is going to come into, to be able to do many of the things that we do in the practice of evaluation. That is something that, through capacity building, through South-South, interactions and knowledge sharing and so on, we can continue to build to build those tools for the community of practice globally.
We talk about capacity building in South-South collaborations, but increasingly the ecosystem is also seeing South-North-South collaborations as well, right? But the scope of that collaboration is very multi-contextual, and it has a lot of different facets that we as an ecosystem have to manage. What does that look like in your experience so far?
I mean, I think at 3IE, what we've seen over the last 15 years, and maybe this applies more broadly to the community of evaluation, is that the global trends of working together across different countries is, I think, is really increasing as the capacity, as the know-how spreads around the world, and we have people who are experienced in doing this kind of work in all corners of the world. What we see, and actually at 3IE, what we promote very actively is having multinational teams working across, north-south collaborations, south-south collaborations. We will many times see projects and studies where we maybe will have principal investigators from both the host country as well as maybe somebody sitting at an academic institution, but that doesn't necessarily mean an academic institution in the Northern Hemisphere or in Europe or the US. It might be another Southern, academic institution on the other side of the world. And so I think this sort of globalization and democratization is an important trend. And I think we're maybe not there yet if there is being sort of fully democratized, but I think we're moving in the right direction.
Everything's a process at the end of the
Absolutely.
Day.
Absolutely.
All right. Thanks so much for your insights. It's been an incredible conversation, Sebastian. Thank you for your time.
Thanks for having me.